You see what I'm saying? Because it's spiritual. The Lord took what he wanted from Connecticut.
Yep.
That's why we're dealing with the issue of the Pequot Indians. Yep. Which, let's go back into the information here, man.
Okay. So we're going to go back into that.
Let's stay on track.
The scriptures.
Yeah. Well, that's the spirit. The spirit is like the one. The spirit wanted us to talk about something else, but now we're gonna revert back to the topic, okay?
Right. Now, Block Island, July 1636. Another death transforms the situation. Members of a Narragansett tributary tribe kill Captain John Oldman. Soon thereafter, a punitive expedition sets sail from Boston under the command of John Endicott to punish the Block Islanders and to demand the killers of John Stone from the Pequots in Connecticut. Captain Endicott believes he is working God's will against the savages. And that's the thing. First of all, we're the people of Yahweh Hashem Yahshua, not you fucking white people.
You're the savages.
You're the savage, all right? You're the fucking savage, not us. It says, after a brief Indian resistance on Block Island, the Indians disappear. Endicott spends 2 days burning their empty villages, shooting stray dogs, and destroying Indian food supplies.
Yeah, being the devil.
Yep. Sailing on to Pequot territory, Endicott meets with Pequot envoys. He distrusts them and believes they are procrastinating. The talks break down and violence erupts. The colonist troops proceed in rampart destruction and looting. The Pequots are furious, directing their anger against the nearest Englishmen. They besiege Fort Saybrook, that's Old Saybrook, Connecticut, which is along the 95 corridor if you're going north, before you get to Stonington. And before you get to those areas where the casino is at. Stonington, Connecticut, Old Saybrook, Connecticut. You got a place called Old Saybrook.
Uh-huh.
It says they besiege Fort Saybrook the following fall and winter and attack the Wethersfield settlement. In response, the English declare war on the Pequots. In the last hours of moonlight, May 26, 1637, English Puritans with Mohegan and Narragansett allies.
Yeah, Uncle Tomahawk Gadites with them, helping them attack other Gadites, man.
That's right.
That was always going on. That's the only reason the so-called white man was able to conquer the so-called Native Americans, because there was a lot of our own people enlisting along with these so-called white people that helped bring us down.
That's right.
Only an Indian can scout and catch another Indian. A white man can't catch an Indian. Well, nowadays, because you got certain crackers that were trained by Indians. How to track other Indians.
Yep.
But back in those days, those white men weren't equipped to do so.
You were inept. Okay, you were inept. You didn't have the aptitude to do it. You had to get Uncle Tomahawk to do it for you, to do the dirt.
Many generations now, we have suffered. The Washichu we spoke to, but they don't hear. They're deaf. The women, the children, the old ones, they suffer. You from the cities, you are our warriors. Our warriors. They're deaf. We must now walk in the sacred way.